right now.
Dead.
Real quick.
Panda just crossed the border not long ago.
Yeah.
Got to a stoplight.
Yeah.
And they rushed.
Yeah. They can spot you.
It's because he was driving a truck.
Yes.
Trucks are very valuable.
Yes.
So they try to rob
you. Yes.
And the reason why I'm playing this video is just to show you guys how quickly things change from like a normal drive to why are they stopping? Is it a car accident? No, this man understood some shit was going on. Very good on him for his quick driving. He managed to not hit anyone, but didn't escalate the situation, but he got out of there safely. Good. Because you don't know what would happen. Maybe they would have taken the house. Maybe they would have just stolen the truck. Maybe they would have killed both. You don't know.
Do we
but know? How fast? How long was that? 45 seconds?
Tops.
Reflex.
It's basically doing what the vibe is with.
What is the first thing he did? U-turn, going back to America. Back to America.
Back up.
Because had he gone deeper,
not
it might have been worse. And if he wasn't in a border town, right? If he was somewhere deeper, there might have been nowhere for you to run. Because you're in their territory.
Not today. That's what else was it. If not today was someone,
that was it.
Oh, not today. Let me back up. What is this? The cartel.
Mans went straight into action. Boom, reverse. Boom, let me find a weave out.
Because he knew.
Then they pull in the second car. The second car was activated to try to trap him in.
Yeah.
Very good.
Yeah.
I mention this because things like checkpoints are very common in foreign countries. And checkpoints are not like...
Not checkpoints by the police.
No. No.
not those kind of checkpoints.
What, checkpoints? Oh, well, we're safe.
No, not those kind of checkpoints.
Yep.
I got some friends in Brazil at night. They don't stop at lights. And they live there.
I got some friends in Detroit. They see a light, they don't stop.
They run it.
Because there's places where you're not supposed to
they
stop.
They run it.
It's dangerous to stop at a red light. Think about that.
Police will tell you.
Yep.
Run it.
Yep.
That's not a violation.
Yes.
That's a trap. Run it. Run that light.
That red light's a hazard.
Run that light.
Red isn't stop. Red is danger.
Exactly. Run it.
It's a different thing.
We're streaming some and watching YouTube and streaming one.
I counted it so many times when I was living in Ethiopia, and that's when like corruption comes into place sometimes, and you gotta pay people off to get through places, right? Money is what makes people move. But when we got there, nigga. Hey, if you wanna go see that store, you go out the big store. That's a great store. But yo, I'm telling you, checkpoints are not meant to be messed with. Vigilance is, and this is what. I was kind of trying to touch on another video in regards to like what it's like when chaos is the norm. When chaos is the norm, you got to get ready for a situation like that. Because I can assure you, I know a lot of people who would have frozen that situation or would have stopped and rolled down the window.
Abba, you're doing
done
it,
for.
You're doing it again.
Do it with
your victim lightning.
Sure. Yeah. I love victim.
Yes, I know. Because when you're from that country or where, from that place, there's no such thing as victim blaming. Victim blaming is actually what you have to do in order not to become a victim. But go ahead. Call it victim blaming if you want.
You gotta take precautions.
It's a privilege.
You gotta take precautions. But again, quick thinking. And this is one situation where not using your gun is maybe the best situation possible. The only reason that, because if you would have fired, they might have just laced the whole thing up.
No, because you don't even know what, you don't even know.
No.
Did you hear the man say cartel?
Yeah.
Did you hear the man say cartel?
But that's what I'm saying. It's not always obvious what the solution is. He chose the best one out of 100 different solutions. He might have drove deeper into territory. He might have taken the wrong turn. He might have been stopped by people. He might have ran them over, tried to kill one. And each of these could have led to a completely different outcome. And so I always take an interest in watching situations like this because I'm like, what's the best way out? What's sensible? What can you do that can most often lead to good conclusions? And this is also why some people just have situational awareness on a platform. So I do this a lot when I talk to this. but sometimes they'll tell you. And you can ask a bunch of veterans, they'll tell you. A lot of them have the same habits. You eat fast. You sit. You don't sit in a booth. You sit on access, close to the exit, someplace where you have your back towards a wall or something. You can see everything that's happening around you. Like, that kind of stuff happens to people where they're situationally aware. I can assure you that that guy, as he was coming to that intersection, had danger already on his mind. Because he didn't even give him a chance to try to play. He was already like, all right, how am I going to do this? And he was calculating in his head. Most people, if you can't sense a danger ahead, you don't know how to make that adjustment. So the best thing is prevention. You're always ready. And that's what I'm trying to say. It's a different mindset.
Learn a language with clickable subtitles.
Got the chat pulled up, so if you want to talk to us, we can. I don't know how long we'll be on here. We might go play Scum or PUBG. Huh? Yeah, as I get it set up, sawed up. They're going down like water.
No Jumper, coolest podcast in the world, and today we have a man.
How y'all doing?
What's going on? Long Beach Griffey in the place to be. I was just showing a lot of your content to like a room full of people, and when I said your name at first, a bunch of people were like, "Who's that?" And then as soon as I put it on, everybody was just like, "Oh, him!"
Yeah.
You have that a lot.
I don't know. Like, I don't really be around it. I'll be out in public and people will be like, "Yo, do you watch him?" And I'll be like, "No, I'm sorry." But I like that because I don't like people coming up to me and telling, "Oh, yeah, like, and talking about my videos." Like, I hate that.
You hate it? Why?
Because I don't like when people, I hate talking about myself. I feel like the only reason you talk to me right now is because of the internet. You feel me? Like, I just don't like that extra attention.
Yeah.
I'm like, say what's up, get your picture, keep moving. That make me feel.
Isn't that a weird thing, though? Because I relate to that to a certain extent, too, where it's like a lot of times when I'm in public, I'm like, Jesus Christ, I just want to be left alone. Like, I can't handle all this fucking attention. But then, at the same time, it's like, well, then why did we dedicate our entire lives to becoming famous on YouTube if we didn't want people to acknowledge us?
Yeah, and it's a double-edged sword because it's like, you don't know if this person is going to be ever see you ever again. So it's like, why can't you be performative and just compromise and leave like 10 seconds of your time to be like, "Oh yeah, thanks bro, I appreciate it. Take a picture." You know what I'm saying? And keep it pushing because they don't know. You know what I'm saying? But at the same time, it's like, move, nigga. I don't want to. You feel me? Like, get out of my face. Like, I'm chilling with my people. I'm changing my son. Why are you behind me right now trying to get a picture?
As soon as you introduce kids into the equation, that's when it starts to get weird. Like, if someone asks me for a photo and I'm like holding my kid,
literally,
I'm just kind of like, doesn't this feel weird to you?
Yeah, that's strange as fuck. Like, people outside of this, outside of being famous, don't understand how fucking annoying this shit is. Like, that nigga, I'm with my kid, and niggas will take pictures and send it to my DMs and be like, "Yo, I caught you slipping. What the fuck? How was that? Nigga, how was that funny? Nigga, that's weird. That's weird.
But like, do you put pictures of shit on the internet?
I do, man. I love
me
my
too
kid.
So much. I can't help myself.
I can't stop. And I told myself I'd never be that nigga. I'd be like, doing that shit every time. Nigga, every time you just be looking, I'd be like,
it's the most entertaining fucking thing in the world. So even though I understand when I see people say, like, "I don't put my kid on the internet, I don't put my wife on the internet, etc. I'm like, I feel you, and you're definitely keeping your life very simplified by doing that. But for me, it's like I'm so used to just, like, I used to put all the drugs and the random girls and all the crazy shit on my fucking story, so it would feel weird to not put, like, the thing I'm currently enamored with, which is my kid, you know,
things that you actually, like, care about. Substance.
It means something to me.
Yeah, definitely.
I put a fry on her head.
How was your job, by the way?
9 months.
How?
Oh, she's great. Amazing.
That's dope.
Wow. She's been sick twice since we had her, so that's kind of worrisome.
Oh, okay.
Not like that, but, like, she had COVID when we got COVID.
Yeah.
And then she just recently was, like, sick again, so kind of weird seeing that happen. How old is yours?
Just turned 7 months 2 days ago.
7 months.
Yeah, 7 months. Learning how to crawl, you know. That's my first child, so me seeing him learn how to crawl, he had his head, dragging his head. I was like, damn, my past caught up to me.
Mm. My kid went from dragging his head in my basket. My kid went from like barely able to crawl to like masterfully crawling in like a week.
Yeah.
It's really freaky. Like, you gotta stay tapped in because that shit just happens so quickly.
Yeah, it does. It does. My son, he struggles still. Like, he get places, but I'm like, damn, son, what is going on?
They're kind of like dragging a leg and shit.
Man, your mama gave that head. I think it's his head.
Mm-hmm. It's got a big head. Yeah, they do. The heads are huge. I mean, my kid, even like 3-4 months in, she couldn't even sit up.
Jeez.
So the fact that she's crawling so good now is like freaking me out.
Yeah. Isn't fatherhood just crazy, right?
It's fucked, right?
It's fucking crazy.
But does it bother you that being a dad means that you can't spend more time doing all the stupid pointless shit that you were basing your life around before fatherhood?
Yeah, I mean, I feel like it kind of humbles you in a way. Mm-hmm. So it's like you go out before. I was just going places just to do it, like just stupid shit. Like, mm-hmm. I was going like.
Yeah, like a stream. That's a stream.
Now you have the possibility. It's like you don't even want to do that stuff, in my opinion. Mm-hmm. It's like all that shit I was doing before, like going to places and like going to seeing all these bitches. And I was just like, I'd rather do it myself. You know what I'm saying? I'd rather do my seed. That's
just
me.
No, you have to do the equation more often of like, you know, when I see my friends out at the club and shit, it's like 4 a.m. and I'm just thinking like, dude, my kid wakes up at like 5-6 a.m.
Right?
How the fuck could I possibly go out and have that much fun?
Exactly. It's like, damn, my son goes to sleep at 10:30. He wakes up at 6 a.m. So I have to, and then you're just planning your life around your child now.
Right.
You feel me? It's not all about your schedule. It's like, it's his schedule.
You're like, still with the mom or no?
Oh, no. We're cool though.
Was it even a possibility, or did you guys break up before the kid even?
Man, it was a lot going on at the time. I can't lie. Like, I was in a love rectangle. So it was like, yeah. It was
a couple different girls involved in this?
It was
a bunch of guys.
It was just, it was a couple of dudes.
I was watching you talk about a relationship the other day on YouTube, and you're just like, man, this is just why I'd be topping dudes.
Yeah,
just be topping dudes.
I'm sucking dick because it's fucking hard. These women are trouble. I was dealing with my ex at the time. We had broken up, and I was dealing with a girl that I was not a rebound necessarily, but it was somebody that I was interested in. And then she came along, the mother of my child, and I got her pregnant. And it was a whole lot of shit. It was too much. I was like, damn, I'd rather just be by myself.
Is there a part of you that's like, damn, I wish I didn't have a kid so I could just focus on just having a lot of sex with just random people?
Nah. I feel like I always manifested a child.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like I always wanted to be a dad. I never wanted to be like an old dad. I never wanted to have kids at 30. I wanted to have children at a time.
36.
Yeah, I didn't want to be Adam. No, I'm just fucking with you. But yeah, like I never wanted to be. I just felt like in my mind at the time I was like, I don't know if I want to. You know what I mean? So like,
what are you doing?
I was always manifesting. I was always going for the goal of having a child between 25 and 20.
Right. Do you feel like at all, you know, financially comfortable enough to have a kid? Was that part of it that you were like willing to let one of the nuts past the goalie just because of the fact that you're doing better for yourself now?
Yeah. Because that's one of the main reasons why, you know what I'm saying, most people don't want to have kids because of financial issues.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So I was like, I'm pretty set. I'm pretty set. So it's like, why not? Like, I can get this thing whatever you want.
Right. Yeah, like, I've heard a lot of people talk about having kids and just be like, there'll never be a perfect time. You should just do it. Yeah. And I'm like, that is not how I look at this at all. It's like,
really?
It's like starting a business.
Right.
You know, you don't start selling fucking hot dogs unless you got enough money to pay for the hot dogs every week, right? Like, you can't have a kid, or I don't think it's, like, smart to have a kid unless you have a plan for how you're going to take care of all the expenses associated with the kid, you know?
Of course. You know, life happens, you know what I'm saying? Even when you feel like you're in the right spot, it's like, it's always something that's just going to come out of the blue and just fuck everything, or just, it just twists everything, and now you have to navigate a different way, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, I feel like
I'm not even dirty as the East Side. Like, I think COVID started on the East Side. I'm being honest. That's where it came from. Like,
but, okay, if you had to, like, basically, like, split up Long Beach into, like, what sides have the most money and shit, I mean, the East Side is, like, the nicest part, right?
No, I don't
Signal know. Hill and shit.
I don't know. Bixby knows, though. Bixby knows. Have you been to, like, the street, the houses in Bixby knows, like, in the rich area?
I can't remember. It's been a long time.
It's, like, it's this area. All right, so going down Long Beach Boulevard before you hit San Antonio, if you make a right, you
My inventory is full.
I'm telling you, literally, it's houses in the back of there that are enormous. I'm talking mansions, like something crazy, yo. It's ridiculous. Mm. Like, ridiculous.
Okay.
Like, Signal Hill? Yeah.
But you didn't grow up in a nice part of town, I'm assuming. Talking about how you didn't have a phone when you started making videos and say you always had to borrow somebody's phone, so I figured it couldn't have been that much.
Ninth grade, I was using my brother's sidekick, his 09. I didn't have a phone to film videos? Not film videos.
Oh, you
didn't have a camera, right? I didn't get into video until after high school.
Epic.
What kind of
video
in high school?
I was pretty goofy. Like, I was a goofy ass dude. Like,
right.
Like, I was chill. Like,
you always like making people laugh though?
It just happened naturally. Like, I never went for it. I never, like, tried to pursue. I didn't go out of my way to make people laugh. I was just a goofy dude. Like, you know that one character? He's just funny just by the way he is.
Mm-hmm.
That's the type of person I was.
Right. But you weren't, like, the kid that was, like, looking up to stand-up comedians and shit? You just were inherently funny?
Yeah, I never wanted to be a stand-up comedian.
Right.
Yeah, I never wanted to do comedy per se. It's just who I am. It's my personality.
Right. Interesting. So many people seem like they like get into doing skits and internet content now, but they were like influenced by fucking Kevin Hart and Chris Rock and Dave Chappelle.
Yeah. I mean, they're definitely people I look up to, people that I admire, definitely, but it was never something I wanted to do. What I wanted to do, I want to be a rapper, Adam. Because I see my brother doing it. My oldest brother, he was a rapper, and I was like, damn, man, I want to do it. So I was still doing a laptop, and I would go in the room, and I would just record all type of like parody songs. Scared to rap my real shit. I thought people wasn't gonna feel my shit when I was in 12th, when I was in like 11th grade.
Right, because I was just playing When a Pedophile Comes to the Studio for the guys. And my boy, who's an actual very good rapper, as soon as he heard your, you know, pedophile verse, he was just like, he's a good ass rapper, like he knows what he's doing. So yeah. he confirmed that, you know, he probably could rap for real.
I'm writing a song about getting my dick sucked. I can't focus on real shit.
It's hard to imagine you being so serious after hearing you rap about, you know, saying I got a 9 on my waist and I ain't talking about a gun. I mean, it just would be like, I feel like that's the whole thing as rappers. It's like the reason why I could never be a rapper is because I would never be able to be serious enough to be a rapper.
Bro, I feel that. And I want to, because it's like, I looked up the type of rapper
now that we are, and someone care or whatever you want to call it.
But niggas are not.
They need to use that. You know what I'm saying?
Some people can't separate the two. You know what I'm saying? When you want to go into different, you know, mediums, you know, like if someone's rapping, being a painter. It's certain niggas like, what, if a rapper, like, I don't know, a rapper went into painting, I don't even know. You wouldn't take him serious, you know what I'm saying?
It's just so hard to get on these
stupid. If Fabulous became an impressionist painter,
he wouldn't. I don't think I could take that serious.
I also feel like Fabulous would get a lot of points for that. Because, okay, you can, if you're a rapper, you could then do things that are, like, more serious.
Yeah.
But if you're a comedian, it's almost like people don't want to see you do things that are more serious. Like,
yeah.
You could go into something that's even goofier than being a comedian.
Yeah.
But you can't, like, be, like... You would probably have a lot of adversity if you tried to be like a super, super serious actor.
I like Adam's like, yeah, shirt. It looks like it's
actually that's why it's hard. It's like, damn. So I have to, at the end of the day, I have to show for, I can't be a rapper. So I have to show them, like, I can rap, but I'm going to do it this way.
We need a new Weird Al, though. Were you a fan of Weird Al?
Are you going to be ready?
Yeah, he just had, you know, he was always just doing like parody versions of every song. I'm gonna think about
it.
Probably
about
like,
30 minutes.
A great time. Like, we need a new Weird Al, like a guy who could have a really big music career from just doing parody versions of all the popular songs.
Yeah, that'd be
consistently watching.
Or when a school shooter comes into the gym.
It's 7 minutes of watch time in the bank.
I like how there's like reoccurring characters of that, like the school shooter just keeps coming back.
You just can't be like, I can't not leave him alone.
Hit that motherfucker subscribe.
What was the first skit that you
talking about my gap, and I was like, you know what, I gotta roast myself, because if I do that, and I roast myself better than everybody else, they can't say anything about me. So I started like
just
that,
ready yet? Yeah,
dang. Feminism and all that shit started happening, the world started getting fucked up, I was like, I gotta start playing music, I gotta
right.
Start, I was like, this is goofy.
Right.
But, yeah, I was still shooting shit, that came out of nowhere.
Oh, one meal rice.
Yep. I mean,
right,
yeah,
I saw
was,
okay, so I need to get a meal.
No, but we had like a lot of people on the podcast. I don't think the gap should like exclude someone from being considered attractive.
Yeah, nah, but I was young.
Cause that's character.
Yeah, I was young, so I didn't really understand. But when I got older, I realized having a gap never stopped me from doing anything. Just like I still have bitches before I had clout. I was still doing jobs. Nothing was stopping me from being who I was. So I was all like, man, fuck that shit. I'm just gonna make it. You know what I'm saying? That's when I was like, that's when I started taking pride. And niggas hit me up all the time, like, oh, yo, man, I was insecure about my gap. But you got it, and you be out here, you did this, and they were like, yo, like, I really appreciate that. Like, you made me feel better about myself.
Yeah, like, I kind of feel like it makes everything you do more funny.
Yeah, I think so, too.
Yeah,
I think so, too.
Like, if you had an afro,
that'd be crazy.
Afros are funny as fuck. Like, I mean, just be real, like, it's just something kind of amusing about, like, I don't know. I just feel like it could work for you.
I always thought mohawks would be
Oh, mohawks are funny. But, like, what kind? Like, the little, like Sean John
like
type, or, like,
one.
A high
I'm
one?
I'm talking about the early 2000s.
Yeah. But, like, imagine being, like, a punk rocker, and that's your life. Is like, you wake up, like, drunk as fuck on somebody's couch, and then you have to take a ton of glue and gel and, like, add
is
that to
all leaning?
Yeah, like, you look like a fucking bozo. And imagine having to live your life where if your hair even gets tapped by something, like, your whole day is fucked. All right, I gotta go home and fix this.
Bro, I gotta go. I gotta go. My shit's, like, leaning out. Can you see this shit?
You get on the subway, you fucking smash that shit. Ah!
Bro, like,
what is that like?
You get into a fight and nigga just start fucking your shit
oh.
up, bro. That was fucking my OCD. I'd be mad.
That was always why I never did a lot of the cornea trends that were popular when I was young, because I felt like they would be too much of a liability in a fight. Like, I never got the giant gauges in my ear.
Yeah, like the oh my god, bro, that was painful.
I just immediately, as a kid, I would just imagine, like, somebody's gonna fucking rip that shit out. I'm gonna have a torn. You know,
yeah.
And all the facial piercings, I felt the same way. That's why I never had long hair. I always felt like, I'm going to get in a fight, and it's just going to fucking be the end of me.
Yeah, I'd be inconvenient as fuck.
Yeah,
that's fucked up.
You see girls fighting, and just hold each other's hair and pound
them.
I was thinking about the other day. I don't think you're wrong in that situation, because if I fight a nigga with long hair, I'm pulling your shit.
Oh,
yeah. I'm pulling your shit. Like, you have to.
I've done it.
You have to. It's smart to do.
The only way, there's a reason why in the UFC they have to have that shit scrapped back.
Exactly. You know? I'm pulling hair. I don't give a fuck.
Yeah,
I don't know why people are so mad about that.
Yeah.
You're pulling your hair. So what?
But have you ever gouged someone's eyes out?
Oh, fuck no. Oh, Jesus. That's why I'm scared to fight, too, bro. Because I don't want to, like, I don't know, bro. I don't know what people are capable of.
That just seems like the most underused move in a fight.
Gouging someone's eye out?
Yeah, because it just seems so easy. Like, if you were rolling around on the ground kind of a little bit, and you just hit somebody with that, boom, you're blind for life.
It's so aggressive.
I win. I know, it's just too
exactly.
much.
Exactly.
It's like the nuclear bomb.
Yes, it's wild.
You know you could win the fight by just dropping a nuclear bomb, but it's like, maybe we shouldn't, because there's, you know, a million people are gonna die.
Yeah.
Like, we might be fighting. I want to gouge your eyes out, but I also don't want you to be blind for the rest of your life.
Yeah, or go to jail. When you're angry, you don't think about that.
It's self-defense to gouge someone's eyes up.
Experian Boost raised my credit score by 12 points instantly, which is insane.
So I raised my score by 21 points instantly. Literally, as soon as I pressed the button.
Boost your credit scores instantly. Free. Only at Experian.com/boost.
Damn, that's a lot. Are you serious? Let's go through that mind. Let's go mind for a minute.
Woo! To all Urban Central, look at as old as we can look. Woo!
That's good that you can know what, where we're starting at. Damn, we got some good fish in that little fishing hole. Hell yeah. I'm finna stop streaming probably. Were you at the living room or the bathroom?
Thank you for calling the fourth.
I'll bring a cigarette there in a minute. I'm gonna sit back and chill for a minute, y'all, and I'll get back on in a minute. After a while, this fish was only worth 800. Shit. Alright, y'all. We'll be back on in a little bit.